Hello, I'm Anthony Hughes, and I'm here to tell you about the new on-screen keyboard, fretboard, and drum pads in Dorico 4. The lower zone is now the home for multiple panels, not just properties. There are other videos in this series where I tell you about the new key editor in write mode, and also the new mixer, which can be viewed in the lower zone. But there are also a series of instrument panels in write mode that help you input and edit your music. The first of these is the keyboard panel. The keyboard can be used for any pitched instrument and replicates the full range of a piano keyboard. You can view different octaves of the keyboard by dragging in the range selector, and you can change the number of visible keys to suit your needs. The keyboard can also be made taller or shorter. The classic use of the keyboard panel is note input, and it works in both step time and real-time input, the latter of which is especially useful when using a touch-enabled device, such as a Windows Surface or similar computer. Common note durations are found on the toolbar, meaning you can close the notes panel and see more of your music. You can also find a button to advance the caret by the selected duration, which does the same job as the space key, and also a button that works as a backspace to delete the most recently input notes. There are also useful keys to respell selected notes. When note input is not enabled, the keyboard panel displays any selected notes. The fretboard panel can be used with fretted instruments, displaying the relevant number of strings and frets. When you input notes using the fretboard panel, Dorico sets the string you used as a property, very useful for tab. The fretboard panel displays a capo when one is defined and shows any selected notes outside of note input. The drum pads panel can be used with unpitched percussion instruments and kits, making them considerably easier to input as you can see at a glance all available instruments. You can arrange drum pads however you like in order to make them more comfortable to use, including adding spaces to create gaps if you choose. When using drum pads for real-time recording, hitting near the center of the pad will result in a higher velocity. If you've enjoyed this video, please consider giving it a thumbs up to let me know, and subscribe to the Dorico channel right now to see much more like this. I'm Anthony Hughes. Thanks for watching.